my shoulder. I've had enough. Can't take no longer. I'm over here. Hi, have you an appointment today?
Hi, yes, I've got an 11 o'clock appointment with Angela.
Okay, let's see. Oh, yes, Sarah, is it?
Yes, that's right.
Lovely. Right then, I'll just get you into a gown and take you to Angela's chair. Okay then, here we are. Lovely. Angela won't be a minute. Can I get you a drink, coffee, tea, whatever?
A sparkling water would be good if you've got one.
Yes, of course. Lovely. I'll be right back.
Hello, my love. Sarah, isn't it? I'm Angela. Oh, I'm sweating already. Oh, it's been mad this week. I'm just saying, it's been absolutely mad, hasn't it, Jackie? Oh, anyway, I expect like everyone else, you're desperate for a cut at the very least.
Oh, yes, please.
Do you know, some of our clients have been in tears coming back after lockdown. It's been horrendous. Some of them have tried sorting out their colouring routes themselves, bleaching and all sorts.
Really?
Oh, you'll believe some of the horrors. One client, right, was so desperate, she asked her husband to give her a bit of a trim. She reckons he butchered it on purpose. She's seriously considering divorce.
Oh!
Anyway, what are we doing today, my love?
Well, I think I'd like a restyle. I want to try something new. Here, I bought a picture on my phone. I'm thinking of having a colour too, but maybe next time.
Okay, that's no problem. Let's have a look. Ooh, bit of a pixie cut. That'll suit you. You've got lovely thick hair. Gorgeous. Right then, Rachel will take you over to the wash basin and I'll see you shortly. She'll give you one of her famous head massages. Everyone loves them.
If you follow me. Okay then, how's that water for you? Not too hot?
No, that's fine.
Lovely. It's brilliant to be getting back to a sort of normal, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not been easy, has it?
No, it's been horrible. Really miss my boyfriend. Although, don't tell anyone, but we did have a couple of sneaky illegal meetups.
Oh, right.
Anyway, can't wait to go on holiday with my mates. My mum's not keen for me to go abroad for a while, but you've got to live, haven't you?
Yes, of course.
Are you doing anything nice?
Not sure. Nothing planned at the moment.
Something to look forward to, though, I expect. OK, just relax and I'll give you a lovely head massage. There we are then. Lovely. I'll take you back to Angela.
Oh, thank you.
Right then, here we are again. So, Sarah, who usually does your hair?
Well, I usually go to Gianni's, but he's closed down since the lockdown.
Oh, yeah, Gianni. He was planning to retire in a couple of years anyway, so he just decided to bring it forward. Rachel used to work for him. Unfortunately, I couldn't take on any more of his girls. It's been good for our business, though. A lot of clients have come to us.
Well, that's good then.
Yeah, it's been really busy. So, have you lived in the town long?
Nearly 10 years, since I got married.
And how have you found this lockdown?
Oh, difficult. Well, like most people, I suppose.
Honestly, I thought if it doesn't end soon, either I'll murder Steve or he'll kill me. I thought I'd best start sleeping with one eye open. Oh, excuse me a minute.
That looks lovely, Mrs. Miller. Oh, Jackie's dressed it up beautifully, hasn't she? I'd that bald spot really well. What do you think, Pepper? There you are then, Mrs. M. Pepper approves. All right, my love. We'll see you next week. Mind how you go. Rachel will see you to the taxi.
Right then. Sorry about that. Mrs. Miller's been coming here for years. Always brings her little dog. Oh, she's amazing for her age. She was 90 in January. We had a bit of a party for her. Of course, did her hair on the house. Oh, lovely lady. Mrs. M's amazing, isn't she, Jackie? Anyway, back to you. So, you said you lived here about 10 years?
Yeah, nearly 10. That's right.
Oh, lovely. Have you got children?
Yeah, two girls, 8 and 6.
Oh, lovely. What decided you to come here then once Gianni closed?
Well, someone I know recommended you.
Oh, who is that then?
Amanda. She's in my Zumba class.
Oh, not Amanda Richards by any chance?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, Amanda. We call her Mad Mandy. Hey, Jackie, guess what? Sarah knows Mad Mandy. Oh, yeah. Oh, she's a cases man. Oh, she's such a laugh. She gets up to all sorts, does Mandy. You know, she'll try anything. She came in here one time and said she wanted one side of her hair blue and the other pink. She wasn't joking either. So we did it and she loved it. absolutely bonkers.
Yeah, well, yeah, she does seem quite lively.
Oh, she's certainly that. She's always got a new man on the go as man. Mind you, I suspect her latest one might be married. I mean, I hope not. She hasn't exactly said so. Just an impression I got, but I'm old-fashioned. I don't hold with that carry-on. It's not fair, is it? Oh, love, are you all right? Sorry, have I upset you? Oh, me and my big mouth. Take no notice of me, love. You okay?
Yeah, sorry. It's silly of me. It's just, well, I...
Oh, here you are, love. The tissue. There, take a sip of your water. There. It's okay.
Thanks. Sorry, I'm just on the edge a bit at the moment. It's just that with...
It's all right, love. No need to explain. I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Oh, stupid of me to get upset. It's just that, well, during lockdown, I got a feeling that my husband was... Well, we've both been working from home, you see, and sometimes he'd get a call and... Well, he'd go off to the bedroom to take it and... Well, he seemed to be whispering and looks a bit sort of sheepish after... Well, I suppose in the office in town he could easily take those kind of calls. Maybe even meet someone for lunch. Oh, or whatever. Oh. Anyway, look, I didn't mean to blurt all that out. I'm sorry for being so silly. Oh, it's probably nothing.
Oh, love, I'm so sorry. Well, like you say, it's probably nothing, really. Maybe he's got some big business deal or something and he needs to concentrate on the call in peace. I mean, I know having kids at home isn't ideal when you're trying to work and you need a bit of quiet.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm being paranoid. Oh, you must think I'm really pathetic.
No, love, of course not. I think we're all feeling a bit uptight, aren't we? Oh, it's all been such a strange time. Don't worry. But do you think maybe you should have a talk with him, you know, get things out in the open?
I probably should, but at the moment there's still a chance I'm wrong. I mean, once he admits it, that's it, isn't it? It can't be undone.
Well, yeah, but wouldn't it be better to know one way or the other? I mean, at least then you might be able to sort it out together. Anyway, of course, it's up to you. Take no notice of me, love.
No, you're right. I'll have a think. I feel a bit better now I've told someone. Thanks. You've been great.
Oh, I expect you'll find it's all just a misunderstanding.
Yeah, I hope so.
Right then. All done. Pop your glasses back on and see what you think.
Oh, I look quite different.
Oh, isn't it what you wanted? It might take you a while to get used to the new look.
No, I mean, it's amazing. I love it.
Oh, good. It really suits you, my love. Yeah, I think some highlights next time will really give it a lift. I'll just get the mirror and show you the back.
Oh, wow. Oh, it's great. Yeah, I'll make an appointment for a few weeks' time for the highlights.
Oh, try not to worry, love. Things may not be what you think. Okay, then. Rachel has sorted the bill for you.
Thanks. And thanks so much for the sympathetic ear.
Oh, no problem, my love. See you in a few weeks. Good luck. Bye for now.
Bye.
Jack, just going to grab some lunch. Back in a bit.
Hi, I've got a 4 o'clock appointment for a cut.
What's the name?
Rob.
Oh, yes, lovely. OK, if you'd like to come this way, I'll just put this gown on you. That's it. Would you like a drink of anything?
Oh, no, I'm fine, thanks.
Hello, my love. I'm Angela. Rob, is it?
Yeah, that's right.
Great. What are we doing today, then? Just to tidy up, is it? And get rid of these lockdown locks, eh?
Yes, please. Be great to have a proper haircut at last.
Everyone's been a bit desperate.
Desperate times, eh?
That's right. Oh, look, I'm really sorry, but with all this social distancing lark, we can't take you over to the wash base until that lady's done, so would you mind just waiting here a few minutes?
Oh, no problem. But you don't need to shampoo it, really.
Oh, no, you always get the full works here. Rachel does a wonderful head massage. You wouldn't want to miss that. Only be a couple of minutes.
Well, okay then.
Great. So, you've not been in here before, have you? Where do you normally go?
Well, I normally go just near the office in town. But we're all still working from home, so I thought I'd pop in here and get it cut.
Oh, yeah. We've had quite a few home workers coming in. Either that or ex-clients of Gianni's.
Gianni? Who's he?
Oh, Gianni had a salon in town, but he's just retired, so a lot of his clients have recommended us. Oh, it's been super busy.
I can imagine.
Yeah, it's been an interesting day, one way and the other.
Oh.
So, have you lived in the town long?
Almost 10 years.
Oh, right, quite a while then.
Yeah, I suppose so. Doesn't seem that long, though.
What made you decide to move here, then?
Well, we like the area. It's not too bad for commuting. Plus, the schools are good.
Oh, you have family, then?
Oh, yeah, two girls.
Oh, that's nice. Sorry, excuse me a second. Just got to check on a client's tint. Yes, that's fine, Rachel. Yeah, you can shampoo that lady now. Oh, back again. Right, what were you saying? I was a bit distracted.
I was saying I had two girls. They're very good, really. Much noisier than you'd think, though. Working from home has been a bit of a strain for my wife and I. Like most people, I suppose.
Yeah, of course. A lot of our clients say the same thing. Hopefully it's lifting now, though.
Yeah, be good to get back to the office, really.
I'm sure. So, what made you choose my salon for your comeback haircut, then?
Oh, someone recommended it, actually.
Oh, right, who was that, then?
Well, her name's Amanda.
Oh, really? Amanda Richards, was it, by any chance?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I see. Sorry, I'm a bit dozy today, been so busy. Did you say you have two girls?
Yeah.
What ages are they?
8 and 6. Why'd you ask?
Just wondered, that's all. So, have you known Amanda long?
No, not really.
Would you excuse me a second?
Sure.
Sorry about that. So let's take you over to the wash basin. It's okay, Rachel, I'll do Rob shampoo and a massage myself. Oh, it's really hot and humid today, isn't it? Jackie will do you one of her famous iced teas to cool you down.
Sounds great.
Just lean back then. Here we go.
I'm sorry, the water's a bit hot.
Pardon my love, I can't hear all this racket going on. What did you say?
The water's boiling hot! Hot!
Oh,
hot!
Dear. Sorry, my love. Here we are, this will be better.
It's a bit cool now, actually. Yeah, quite cold.
Oh, nice and cooling, is it? Lovely.
It's freezing cold.
Oh, dear. Oh, sorry, I'm not used to these taps. Oh, Rachel usually does it. Oh, that's good. How's that?
Oh, yeah, that's a bit better. Yeah, thank you.
That's good. Ooh. You just relax now, my love, and I'll give you a lovely head massage.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, would you mind being just a little bit gentler? That's actually hurting quite a bit.
Oh, that's just because you're not used to it. Just relax. It's really good for your follicles.
Yeah. Ow! Please stop. It's hurting. Look, I don't want the massage.
Oh, okay then. What a shame. Right then, let's head back over to the chair. Follow me. Okay, take a seat and have a lovely big sip of your iced tea. It'll cool you down again before we start.
That's not iced tea. It's boiling hot black tea, for goodness sake. It burnt my tongue.
Oh, no, I'm so sorry, my love. Oh, Jackie must have got confused. I'll have to have a word with her. Not really having a good day, are you, Rob?
You could say that.
I'll just dry this off a bit. Right. If you could put your head down, we'll sort the back first, and then I'll spin you round to face me and finish off at the front. I shall be using my trusty clippers.
Okay.
Good. Won't take long.
Ow! Ow! Oh, look, sorry, would you could be more careful? Your nails are so long, they're digging into my neck.
Oh, really? Oh, dear, poor you. You must be super sensitive, my love. I'll try and be more gentle.
Oh, please.
Nearly done. Anyway, you were saying Amanda's a friend of yours.
Well, no, I wouldn't exactly say a friend.
A very, very good friend, perhaps?
What? No, I'm not sure what you mean.
Hmm. How did you two meet, then?
We didn't meet. I've never met her. Just spoken on the phone.
Really? Is that so?
Look, I'm not sure what you're getting at, but Amanda is simply the girl at Phoenix Travel that's arranging a trip for me.
Trip for two, is it? Anywhere nice?
Yes, as a matter of fact. Venice.
Oh, how very romantic. I wonder what your wife would think of that, or is it a business trip?
My wife doesn't know.
I bet she doesn't.
What the hell are you suggesting? Look, although I really don't know what it's got to do with you, she doesn't know because it's a surprise for our 10th wedding anniversary, as it happens.
What? Wait. Sorry, Mandy's been arranging a trip for you?
Yes.
And it's a surprise?
Yes.
For your wife?
Yes, why? Look, I don't know what this is all about, but honestly, I think I've just about had enough. I'm leaving and definitely shan't be coming back. So if you're just... Oh, my God! What the hell? What have you done my hair? It's I look ridiculous!
Oh, it's just a style now. Most guys love it, don't they, Jackie?
I look an absolute idiot. What the hell's going on here? I don't know what I've done to deserve this treatment. You've not only boiled then frozen my head, dug your talons right into my neck, burned my tongue, and now to finish off, have made me look like, I don't know what, this hideous, ridiculous... I can't believe you could get away with this kind of treatment. I shan't be paying, obviously.
Oh, no, of course not. Sorry, it was just a misunderstanding. I just thought...
Forget it. God knows what my wife's going to say.
Well, you never know. She might actually be quite relieved when you...
Relieved? I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. You are completely insane. It's outrageous. Obviously, I shan't be recommending you to anyone else ever.
Angela Salon. Oh, hi. Yeah, she is. Hang on a sec. Ange, Mandy's on the phone. She said, can you fit her in? She's got a hot date tonight.
I tried everything, but it's useless. He pushed me so far, now I'm on.